What's up, YouTube? This is Thomas from Thomas Invest, and thank you for watching. Today, I want to talk about McDonald's, ticker symbol MCD. This is the one we all grew up with. Everyone has visited McDonald's one time in their life. It's one of the most popular companies, and in this video, I want to show you my fundamental analysis to see if McDonald's is a buy. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe to get notified when I'm posting a video. I also appreciate an early thumbs up, which helps me within the YouTube algorithm. For now, let's dive into it. McDonald's has a lot of franchise owners. In this chart, we see that almost 93% of all the McDonald's is owned by independent local business owners. So McDonald's get a lot of revenue by selling their name and building to those franchises. This may change a lot of the fundamentals and also how to look at it. Let's start with the PE ratio. McDonald's has a PE ratio of 34. This is above 20 and also a red X, of course. This worries me a lot because it might indicate that McDonald's is overvalued. Profit margin is at 26%, so they do a great job. A big chunk. This might be confusing, but most of the McDonald's revenue is generated by franchise revenue and not selling products. So it's logical that margins are higher, because food products have lower margin. Since 2016, the revenue is down 25%. This worries me a lot and it's also a big red X. I think that people are eating healthier and don't go that much to McDonald's anymore. The confusing part of the story is that McDonald's is opening more stores every year, so you would expect also an increasing revenue, but we simply don't see that. Profit is up a little bit since 2016, so it's a tough one. But I think it isn't fair to use last year data for McDonald's because of all the shutdowns. If you take a look at the previous 4 years before 2020, you see a steady increase in profit. This means profit is going up big time while revenue is going down. Both return on assets and return on investments are above 10% in the past 5 years, so it's a check. Since 2018, both are going down. You might want to check this yourself. McDonald's is buying back shares, so it's a big check. This means you own more of the company because there are less shares outstanding. I really like to see big companies like McDonald's buying back shares. With the current ratio, you want to check if the company is capable of paying the current liabilities with the current assets. You want this number sitting at 2, where 1.5 is the absolute minimum. McDonald's has a current ratio of 1.19, so it's a red X. But keep in mind that McDonald's has a lot of properties, so you might want to compare this to a REIT sector and not to the food sector. Free cash flow is up since 2016, but it's not consistent. But it's still a check. I don't like the way it goes, but as long as it goes up, it's fine. If we take the 5-year average of McDonald's free cash flow, we get 4.5. I use 3 growth multiples as always, and you will see the outcome in these 3 scenarios. To be fair, I think with the revenue going down and people try to eat healthier, a low multiple would be fair. I don't think it would be justified to use a mid or a high multiple, but please feel free to use those. We see that McDonald's is overvalued in all the 3 scenarios, so even when you assume McDonald's is going to grow big time in the coming years, you still buy a company that's overvalued and you spend too much money on this stock. I think a fair stock price would be around $90, and I'm not sure if I would buy this company because revenue is going down. It's also a red X because it's overvalued big time. As I said, I will skip this stock. It's a nice company and people love it because of all the dividends. I heard people say McDonald's has a moat, but I don't fully agree with that. Yes, it's the most popular fast food restaurant in history, but people are trying to eat healthier, so the moat is drying up. And please remember to always do your own research and never fully trust on what I or other YouTubers say about a stock. I'm not a financial advisor and this content is just for entertaining purposes only. I hope you liked this video and I did bring some insights of the company to you. I would really appreciate a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to get notified when I'm posting a new video. Thanks for watching and I will see you in my next video.